The SCoK has cleared the way for President Uhuru Kenyatta to assume the instruments of power and constitutional authority. It is game over for the legal challenges and the beginning of the last 5 years of Uhuru as president. NASA leadership and the supporters have their fate and choices in their hands. There is choice to wild time in endless demonstrations, boycotts and political tailspin chase, and there is a choice to engage in negotiations, pursue secession and measures which move us close to creating autonomous regional governments. The well-being, welfare and subsistence of the Nasarites must be the focus of the movement, and that disruption of economic and social activities and links results to systematic life difficult circumstances unnecessarily. The ball is now in NASA leadership's hands and in the Nasarites' court. They have choices to either run with the ball tactfully to the desired goals or drop it and wallow in endless protests. It's time for the NASA leadership to chart a clear and acceptable way forward that is selfless and to begin preparing for the 2022 elections now, should all else fails. The political Nasarites in Kenya will now officially begin the difficult part of their journey. For the Israelites, it was between Rephidim and the wilderness of Sinai, and for the Kenyan Nasarites, between secession, self-determination and the fully constitutes brute force from Jubilee administration. The political Kenyan Nasarites are in a political Sinai Peninsula, wandering in a wilderness with a difficult terrain, harsh conditions and precarious chances to succeed.